Three, two, one. Hit that button.
This is RJ Radio.
And some of it is so stupid, but I love it.
Only on Live365.com.
The following program is brought to you in living color.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Say what?
I love that. I am a simple man. My simplicity in joy in the morning for a year. That's all I need. I just need
a million pieces like you always do.
Nice.
Oh, see how I got kind of like, good morning, everyone. It is July 16th. That is a Tuesday. Here in the year of our Lord 2019, we're here at the top of Rancho Cucamonga, and it's who? Roy and Jimmy? It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning! My name is Roy Brewster, this is...
I am Jimmy Shaw. Good morning, everybody. You guys, you know what, in that our little Facebook Live video preview, you guys warmed our hearts so much that we just don't know what to do with ourselves now.
You warmed my cockles.
Yeah, our cockles are ready and warmed up and good to go right now. For this Tuesday, this summer day, let's give everybody a nice little, let's give everybody a shout out. Let's give everybody some props here. There you go. Thank you for joining us this morning. This is how me and Roy feel.
Right now, those are my cockles clapping.
I got my boy Otis in there, Kathy from Apple Valley, High Desert, whatever you want to call it, Shauna Whitlock, Vic Vasquez. I mean, a plethora of old friends, new friends.
All friends unite.
It's a new day, Roy Brewster. It is a new day.
We are the glue to your life. We are...
hold it
well,
together.
Actually, not a glue. We're more like a paste.
Some old... It's like Elmer's glue you left out for about a half hour. We're still a little sticky. But we're congealed into one.
Oh, you know what?
You like that?
How about the rubber cement we had in school?
Oh, snots.
Snots.
Boogers.
You put them on a table and make boogers out of them?
Make boogers hanging right off the bottom of your nose.
And ready for this? Huh. The smell of that, yes. All chemical.
Intoxicating.
There was probably a lot of reason that we are the way we are today because we did a lot of things
like,
with
it,
that.
It, like in Fast Times, where the mimeographs, where you smell the paper, it's like, oh, freshly off the press. Yes, that's what it'll do to you. That'll make you morning show hosts. So please, kids, keep on doing what you're doing.
Right.
Sniff it, smoke it, inject it, enhance your lives.
Insert it.
What did Bill Cosby say? People, why do you do cocaine? He says, intensifies my personality.
Right.
Bill Cosby said, but you know, what if you're an asshole?
What if you're an asshole?
Which is pretty true. I
wonder if he's telling that joke right now.
Oh, he's killing. He's getting standing O's. And that's just him standing up. He can't sit down. He can't. You know, it's prison. Right, Vic?
Right, Vic?
If you're not working, Vic, you got to call us in. There's done. All friends matter. Absolutely.
That's right.
There you go. My sister. There you go.
There you
go. Another one from the... You know, I'm going to just keep this button going on right here. Another one from my sister. Good job. Good job, everybody.
The Donna that we really care about.
The Donna who is by our side.
The Donna who we can't live without.
You can't. Well, you know, by law, she's my sister, but also by choice.
By choice.
Yeah. I have to. Roy doesn't.
No, but I do. The Donna that we...
The Donna who went to Irvine Improv.
That Donna.
To support her boys.
Not this one.
Not this one.
Not this one.
Blah, get the blah, get the blah, blah, blah.
Not that one. She's... you know what's going to happen?
What's that?
She's either going to come in one day, and then I'm going to give her a lot of shit one day.
Yeah.
And she's going to whoop out a little stubby 22 and shoot me in the brain?
Just right there at the stem.
Right. Or is she just going to leave?
Now, everybody in the YouTube chat room and
also... In both ways.
In both ways.
In either way that happens,
yeah,
it'll relieve me of Donna. So either way it works. Go ahead.
You're
YouTube chat
it.
Room, Jimmy.
Okay. Everybody in the YouTube chat room, keep an eye out and we'll keep you your ears up to date on this. If you're not in there, we're looking for an Elizabeth Stevenson.
Yes.
In the chat room now.
Yes. Hopefully she got it figured out.
Roy's mom having a little trouble signing in as herself.
Yep.
So for the last 6 months, me and Roy have been guiding, nurturing, coddling, caressing, yeah. molding her into a modern internet woman.
Well, we're trying to say we jumped her right into 1999.
So what I did was, on behalf of the Roy and Jimmy Morning Show, it's created an account for her to sign into.
Right.
All by herself. Yep. Her lonesome. Her own.
Yep.
One piece of the world.
Right.
This earth that she can claim as her own. With an included password.
Yep.
Which is pretty clever of me.
Oh, it was pretty good.
It was pretty good, right?
Yeah. Yep.
And I had the backing of her number one child here.
Mm-hmm.
Send it on its way.
That didn't work, bad mold. How does it not work?
Oh, mother.
All you have to do is sign out and sign in with the one that Jimmy gave you.
We'll go over that.
Later.
And I signed in on YouTube yesterday as you,
right.
And it works.
It works.
So we'll get you through it.
We'll
Mama.
Get you through it. Don't
and
worry
if
about
not,
it.
Grab Leah, grab one of the youngins in the house there.
Right. And tell them, yeah.
Tell them, help your grandma. You owe me, you little bitches.
Yeah.
You owe me. But good morning, Mom.
Good morning.
Good morning, everybody. So it is July 16th. It is Tuesday. It's 7:07. We are here to rock your world for 2 hours.
So I saw last night the lovely Ariana's picture of her lasagna.
Yes.
Looked delicious. Was it like a bake thing? So
I can't tell if Mom gave us a smile or the finger.
It's a smile.
Okay.
So
it's so... Can you read that? That's so small.
And it was about, and I almost brought it up yesterday, and then we went off on another tangent, and I didn't. And I know you're doing that thing. It's working well for you. I've done it before in the past.
Right.
With the carb deal. And I don't know if you remember, but like 5 weeks ago, we were doing a Roy weigh-in on Mondays.
Oh, right.
We were
going to begin that. Yeah.
Yeah. And we did it 1 week, and then we didn't do it anymore.
And then no.
So that was my inspiration yesterday in the morning. I'm in the same zone as you are right now.
Okay.
And that's just it. Well, I'm going to do. Because I like to eat food. I hate looking at calories. I want to cut out carbs. Just like I've done before.
Right.
But I got to tell you one thing.
You've done it successfully.
I had a dream.
Yes.
Now, you know you have a problem with the food, you know, with it being so important
right.
in your life.
Sure, sure.
If while you're dreaming... You're dreaming of getting ready to eat something, right?
Yeah.
And everyone's going to eat and you're waiting forever. And I don't remember a lot about the dream, but I remember this. I was with friends and stuff and the food was coming. I was excited to eat it.
Right.
And I remember talking to myself in my dream. Okay. Don't wake up until the food comes. So when I woke up, I'm like, wait a minute. Are you freaking kidding me? Don't wake up.
Don't wake up
until the food comes. So I didn't want to get out of my dream until the food came.
So you were living vicariously through your sleeping self.
Right.
Gotcha.
How in the hell? I mean, when I'm sleeping, I'm not going to be eating it, but I'm be dreaming I'm eating it.
But you, at least you you're such a goofball.
Don't wake up until your food comes.
You're so funny, dude.
What happened there?
That's your mind. That's your subliminal. Now, see, Ariana's implemented this diet, and I've seen it. It's a success. She's done it before. You've done it before.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you can tell.
Right, it works.
You know what's going on. And
I had to plug in.
And I've gained about 25 extra pounds with the non-working thing going on.
Uh-huh.
And I've told everybody, excuse me, it shows in my belly.
Belly.
I don't distribute. I load
He's a belly
it.
Guy.
It stays in the dock right here in the garage. So I said, sure, I'll jump in there. Well, you get a few days into it, maybe even a week, and you start missing and craving
little things
what you used to eat.
Sure.
And I have not had that problem. Only because, first of all, the stuff I used to eat is not in the house.
Right.
And I never went to go get it. It was there.
Right.
And I've told Ariana, I'm sorry, guys. I'm, wow. That's so bad form. But we're real people. That's why. So she said, well, are you missing the lasagna things you made last night? It was right. The squash noodles.
Right. And you know what? Honestly, I love those.
They're fine. And
because they're not so heavy.
Right. She says, are you missing the pasta? I said, no. Are you missing this? I am not. And the deal is I eat everything.
Right.
So to take anything away from me, it's like, well,
you got a lot of options.
It's okay. It's all good. If it tastes good, I'm going to eat it. And so far, everything she's whipped up has been delicious.
Well, and the reason that I like it when I've done it before, I mean, the last run I was on was big calories and wasn't, I mean, it wasn't horrible. It was, the amount of calories I can have and lose weight is a lot.
Right.
But I still feel part of it's like, you know, I don't know. But, and here's the other deal. All diets work.
They do.
If you follow everyone to a T, they work.
Right.
The problem is finding the one that works for you.
Exactly. One you're comfortable
with. And
the one
you can sustain with.
One you're comfortable with, one that, yeah, exactly.
So I'll take the over on 716, Lisa. So I just want to share the part that, you know, as I'm dreaming, I do say that. Don't wake up until the food comes. I was a little ashamed, but it made me laugh. Now, I think there's a reason, too, that made me dream of food like that.
The visual? Oh, yes.
Yeah,
yes, you had a side effect going on.
We had a little excitement here. In the mountains of Rancho Cucamonga, in the bottom above the 210 freeway here, I come home. I'm not doing my duck business, and I come home, and I'm home about half hour, 40 minutes, and the lovely Kylie comes home and says, "Oh my God, did you see what's going on down the street?" And I don't know. I'm in here, you know, doing work, and so I look out. I just turn around, look out the window, and there's cop cars everywhere. Down the street.
A plethora of patrol vehicles.
Like a lot.
Loaded. The place is just wall to wall.
And she says, yeah, there's guys walking around in like heavy jacket gear and like almost looking like SWAT guys.
Flak jackets.
I'm like, son of a bitch.
The whole thing.
That's crazy. So we're trying to find out what's going on. I'm looking for the scanner channel. I want to listen. I can't find it.
Go to the forums.
Right. And then Dawn comes home, and I'll go back to where Dawn's at. When she comes home, I'm like, did you look down the street? And she didn't see it. She's pulled in our driveway. It's like behind her.
Right.
Unless she came from the other way. And she goes, no. And I'm like, look. And you can see the lights all flashing down there still. And she goes, wow, what's going on? I don't know. So we come in. Kylie drove by and had a couple pictures. And we're like, man, look at that. I mean, there's a lot of people there.
Right.
Can't find out what's going on. So we have, I don't know if anyone else has it, we have this Nextdoor app where you can post what's going on in the neighborhood. It's kind of cool. Some people drive me up the freaking wall, but it's kind of cool, informative. So the lovely Dawn Brewster posts on there, you know, anyone know what's going on this street right by us? And the only answer we got was probably be a shark attack.
Ha ha.
Ha ha. Funny one.
Thanks for piping in, asshole.
Good one. So, well, then we got a message from one of our neighbors privately. Now, this is alleged, but sounds like it probably happened. It's probably going to be 10 houses west of us. Mm-hmm. They found approximately 1,300 pot plants in.
Yes.
Boom.
Yes.
1,300, and the truck and trailer were to haul the pot plants away.
Nice. Good haul.
Now,
We scored.
Yeah, also apparently, we're going to go down afterward and see if we can pick up any crumbs.
Stems and seeds, baby.
Stems and no stems, no seeds that you don't need. Acapulco gold is badass weed. Cheech and Chong, right?
Cheech and Chong, okay. Baby.
So,
Dave's not
we're
here.
We're gonna make a couple. Do they still do dime bags? I don't know. That was a long time ago. You probably get a lot less for $10 than you used to back in the day.
No idea.
Well, yeah. I heard. I didn't ever do that before.
No. Maybe. It's all just conjecture. Yes.
So
never convicted. Always accused.
Well, the funny thing is, when I went out and saw Dawn in the garage when she got home, tell her to look down the street. I thought I smelt a little waft of a ganj
from the missus.
And I'm like, that's kind of, and I know she's not, she doesn't do that. You know, I don't, we don't, but I'm like, I could just smell a little in the air and I thought, nah, you know,
right.
Maybe someone cut the grass and nah. Well, the neighbor that responded to her privately said that the son went down there, was asking questions and talking to the cops and neighbors. He just goes, I'm going.
Went in the mix.
So when he went down there, he said that when they were cutting and pulling all the plants out.
Yeah.
It just smelled like solid weed down there. And I'm like, that's probably what we smelled. So that's why, even though it's allegedly this may have happened, I'm going towards the side that it did because I had the smell after.
Right.
So that's what made me have the dream to say, don't wake up until you eat.
You had the munchies.
Yeah.
You had, let me see if this works out good. Hopefully it does, because this...
Why don't you get a job, Spicoli?
Oh, shit.
What for?
You need money.
All I need are some tasty waves, cool buzz, and I'm fine.
I like where Rudy put. He hits his head with the shoe.
Yeah.
That's my skull!
That was my skull.
So that was excitement over here in the Cucamonga's Ranch. And now the strange thing is...
Yes.
There's no mention of this anywhere.
None.
I've gone to the Ranch Cucamonga Police Department Twitter, their Facebook page. I've gone to the Ranch Cucamonga news groups. I've gone to the local papers. I get news alerts. I've been to the apps for the neighborhood. Nobody has said a word.
That is odd.
Odd.
The way all the real housewives of Beverly Hills all henpeck everything. Did you hear about it? Well, you know, they told my friend, and they said, so nothing on the pot bust. Wait, see, well, that might have hit too close to home.
Right.
That's what these bitches need.
So I don't know what's happening.
The pain of plastic surgery needs that ease of the medicinal.
Yeah.
And they may have, they lost what they needed for this.
Now, what I was also told is no one lived in that house.
One
of them. They say no one lived there. Just a pot house. That's it.
Oh, I see.
Just a grow house. I'm sorry. That's, technical term. Grow house.
Are they like dummy cars? People just pull in and just to make it look like it? How would you pull that off?
I don't know.
Obviously, you can't pull it off.
Obviously. Well, I mean, I don't know what because I hear when you have one of those type of places, one of the things I always read, that they're easy to spot sometimes or find sometimes just because of the electricity bill alone.
Yeah, electricity bill just is cranked. I mean, it's just up on there. And plus, no one's around.
Right.
It's kind of weird.
So, I mean, they're probably going, Edison's going, yeah, this guy's spending $5,000 a month electricity. Something might be going on in that house.
That meter's just
maybe
spinning around. I got to pull this one. So. I got one more for you.
Awesome! Totally awesome! All right, Hamilton.
I fucking love that movie.
look at... Mom popped in and said, if you remember, I told you guys in the morning when I would smell it.
Oh, well, look at you.
Uh-huh.
Not so full of shit now, is she?
Right down the street. Right. Like, so as you turn, you come straight down our street, only two houses, and you go right down that one, like about eight houses down there.
Well, you're basically the catcher's mitt of this, the end of the street. Right. So, yeah, that breeze comes through.
Yep. So if Mom, I sit here from the office.
Your mom's back there just loading down on the Fritos. And you go, Mom, what's wrong with you? She goes, I don't know. I just want some Fritos.
So now I'm blaming it on that on my weight control. What are you going to do with that? It's in the air all the time. And these people, I'm this next door. These people will post anything.
Yeah, exactly. The most nitpicky, jumping everyone's business bullshit. But no one talks about the big bust like that.
I was telling Jimmy about one that happened, not too long ago.
The not too long ago?
Right.
Okay.
See if I can.
We like the not too long ago.
Wow, well, it's so long ago, it's not even on there anymore.
It's gone.
I can probably find it. So, it was about 3 in the morning.
It was the middle of the night.
It was the 3rd of September. Is that what it was? Wasn't it the 3rd of September?
It was the 3rd of September. Yes.
Okay, anyway.
That day I always will remember.
Yes, I will remember. So... there was...
Yes, I will.
Yeah, it's such a good song.
Oh, you know what we need to do then?
Do it. You play it.
You know I'm going to. Because this is what we do. This is what I do. So let's go over here. I'm going to explain to everybody what I'm doing. We're going to go over here. Because it's got some good... That's some good bed music for you right there. All right, go ahead. Three in the morning.
I like it. So I look in the... Why do you all of a sudden do that? So I look in the app. This was on June 30th, 2019. And someone posts in the Nextdoor app where no one's posting about what's going on now, which I'm a little surprised about. It says, who's the nut job racing up and down Carnelian at 4 a.m.?
Little Ricky Racer, 4 in the morning. Yeah.
Now, we heard it. Very loud. Like going crazy.
Just blasting through.
And Don, I wake up. and I'm hearing it. Don wakes up, looks at me, goes, "You hearing that?" I'm like, "Yeah." And we listen for a minute, go, "That's a car." And you can tell he wasn't being chased. He was by himself, firing stuff off, going one way, and then all of a sudden taking off, going up down Carnelian. It was obvious. So people were losing their mind. I went out, looked like he did donuts everywhere. Well, he got our attention, annoyed everyone. Hope he feels better. So dangerous, possibly. Unfortunately, when I went to see, I couldn't grab his license plate. Pretty long time. Fireworks at midnight tore my dogs up. Now this dog scared us. I mean, this guy scared my dogs. Heard him all over the place. I was hoping for a loud crash. Someone said, "I hope this guy is so disrespectful. He's now ruined our property value because he puts donuts in the middle of the intersections."
Now is this little nosy person out there with the little brush out there trying to clean him
up?
Now yeah, that's your concern.
Now here's where it gets funny. A couple people I want to say there. It says, "Y'all forget we were all once kids. We had loud cars. I'm sure at the time we bugged our parents and neighbors. Y'all need to get over it." Now, I remember Crawford and 13th Street.
The old guy.
The old guy used to look at us about blow the tires off my car every time.
We did it on purpose. Yep.
Pissed him off. And this one says, "So I have to teach my little ones, especially 3 and 1 year old, not to freak out over a large loud shaking noise at 4 a.m. in the middle of their sleep. Could you please tell me how I can do that?" Now here's where it gets fun. Someone responds to that. Says, "Easy, tell them it's a loud car and go back to sleep." Jesus.
I tend to go to what the one
that
of the
guy
first,
said.
Yeah, tend to go to one of the first comments. It's like, you know, "God, I hope you crash. I hope you wreck your car and learn your lesson that way." Obviously, not hurt anybody, but I just love someone that's just a T-bone, a light pole when they're doing shit like that.
And someone's posting these two people that are just telling people shut up.
Mm-hmm.
It says, "You guys are my heroes." So I did post on it as well. And I said it was loud, probably inconsiderate, may have been dangerous. And from where we live, it lasted about 5 minutes. I will have to say that whatever it was sounded pretty good. So it cracks me up that someone says they're talking about, do me a favor. Where's the one that talked about the other? But it's just like people are so upset. And when I went and looked at the intersection, of course I did the next day, I had to drive up and down, look at the skid marks. And sure enough, there are donuts on every large intersection all the way up.
He hit every intersection, marked his territory.
723. I told you I got the over.
You did. Funny enough, we were out and about on Sunday, and this nice-looking 5.0. I mean, you know, they're old now, but this one is nice, cranberry red, gorgeous with the rims. Just looked really good. And then it left the intersection, and I apparently put one of them Honda pipes on there.
Yeah.
And it was just like, bleh. I told Ariana it sounded like Roy's wet fart. This thing was just, this car sounded terrible, just terrible. It's like, why are you noise polluting? Why would you, a nice-sounding car like that, and ruin make it sound like that? Roy's wet fart. That is your hashtag for today.
Ooh.
Hashtag Roy's wet fart.
I don't know.
And for Donda to come in on Roy's wet fart.
That's quite a description.
That's quite the tone we have set here. Here's how that Mustang sounded. That was it taken off.
So
horrible.
Now, how that can get 206 posts or something.
Right.
And not one response to the alleged drug house 10 houses from here.
To the assault flak jacket, maybe SWAT, maybe not SWAT.
1,300 pot
shit
plants.
Shit going on right here.
Yesterday?
Near a major freeway.
Nothing?
Nothing.
Something's up.
I think your mom was high. I think everybody was high in the street, and they just did. They thought it was the coolest shit. They thought they were watching Netflix.
Well, I'm kind of thinking now that I'm thinking about it. Is maybe it was Rancho Cucamonga's pot house.
Dun dun.
City officials were growing it to make a little money on the side.
Oh, I see.
In a vacant house. So they had to go, how are we going to get all these pot plants out of here? They said, let's just do a drug raid. We put them on our trailer and we take them and no one knows where they went.
So basically they didn't bust the house. They just harvested the crop. And another 6 months, this thing's going to go back and they're going to say,
oh my God, they came back.
They came back because nobody responded.
Right.
So now they're all looking at each other. I can't believe no one knows this shit.
What's going on?
You know, and you three on this street who are concerned, they don't really care about you. You're outnumbered.
Well, drop my house value.
Roy told me about it. I said, and you didn't get us any?
I think we can walk. At break, we should walk down the street and see if we find any stems or seeds.
Yeah, that would be hilarious.
You know what's funny? Because they had to drag them out somewhere. There's got to be a seed that fell on the lawn somewhere.
Oh, it's a mess.
So about, you know, a couple weeks from now?
Yeah.
Go out there and all of a sudden the front yard.
The grass has weeds and it's like not that kind of weed.
That kind of weed. And let's go light them with a lighter. Make the whole neighborhood stank. And I'll have another dream saying don't wake up until you eat.
Don't wake up until you eat. And also do not wake up until you see the eyes, the whites of Spicoli's eyes.
That did never happen.
That didn't ever happen.
That didn't never.
Is that what you said?
Yeah, that's what I just said.
Whatever. Your speak tone is. Your speak tone, Roy, is commendable. I like it.
Wow. So that was our evening. Last night.
For you, Miss Donna Main.
CSI Rancho Cucamonga.
Huh? We're breaking it down.
We had a lot of stuff going on, Don.
Major drug bust going on.
Drug bust going down the street.
Cool.
You missed it. Ready, hold up. This is what that car sound like. Jimmy heard.
Yeah, it was terrible. Back in the media, let's see here. We had a...
Awesome! Totally awesome! All right, Hamilton.
All right, Hamilton.
Love that one. Well, look at that. We are burning through the time. We're doing so well on the timage right here. We're going to call it timage right here. We're going to take our first break here. It is 7:27 right here on the old Roy and Jimmy in the Morning with Donna Main Show. Give us a call at 909-509-4063. Oh, the eggs.
Oh, I almost sound like sound like Clinton for a minute.
You did.
I'll tell you.
I did not. You have need to sex give us a call. With that woman.
You need to call us at 909-509-4063.
Oh, shit. Never mind. 4063.
Cheese. Roy and Drag, these are the moments I keep giving right there.
I just
wish we had pictures.
Right?
Yeah.
Sort of documentation
of
such a thing.
I really would like to see that.
You know what's funny? I'm all like, no, but I don't care. I'd show them to you.
Right.
I don't give a shit. I wish we had a picture. What the one I wish I had? Oh, I wish I had a picture in the One Piece. Oh, Jimmy.
My One Piece modeling day right there, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was Aunt Barbara's, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I fit in that goddamn thing there. It is 7:40 in the morning. We're in Jimmy in the Morning with Donna Main, and we are just getting your Tuesday going on. We had a lot of people in the Facebook video feed. A lot of people we hadn't heard from or seen in a long ass time. A big old reunion right there.
Nice.
So that was fun there. But
very nice.
We don't seem to have Italy today. So our global domination was only for one day, which is fine.
What's up? And Derek's still there.
Derek's still there, and we gave the weather. He gave us the weather report.
And
so.
What's Oh my God, the girl from the movie. I can't remember her name right now. It lost me again.
Oh,
Steph.
What's her name? Anyways, her.
Yeah, she's there for that movie. We're getting rich off.
That's right. But she's been there a while. Yeah, that's some. She's burning some money out there. That's nice.
Yeah, what's she doing? Where's she getting the money?
Well, you seen her, man. They were dressed all to the nines and everything for the reunion.
Again, a lot of people I'd like to talk shit about, but I can't talk shit about her because she's pretty cool.
Yeah, she's nice.
She's a sweetheart.
And she's in Italy.
Italy with the Holden clan and with the DiStefanano.
And the Derek Murray, delegation.
How the hell did Derek get in there?
I don't know. Maybe his woman's loaded or something. I don't think all that Verizon money got him overseas.
You know,
he'd be great for the replacement if he was the, you know, can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Derek would be great for that. Yeah. They really should look at the ad campaign for him.
I still think he should have been Aladdin.
Oh, yeah. No, hands down.
Yeah.
Hands down. I mean, he sings, he dances.
Has anyone seen the new Aladdin?
Nope. Yeah, don't really need to.
Because Derek wasn't in it, so yeah. I'm not going to.
Now, Robin Williams is the bar, and no need to go again. do not need to redo again. You know, when I'm going to reboot, I'm going to reboot it up your ass. Leave these classics alone, man.
Some bitch. Nasty in here.
I realized the other day that next month it'll be 5 years since Robin Williams died.
That's crazy.
2014. Right. I know. I was like, what?
Yeah. Someone posted something that really blew me away. Was someone said, and it got into a deal, talking about John Candy.
Right.
That blew me away. That's like almost, that's like 30 years ago or something.
Right, yeah.
And I'm like, what?
I think he died like on my birthday or day before or something like what? That. But yeah, so long ago, but you remember like yesterday and you're just like,
Certain things, yeah. And you go,
people.
Where did those last 5 years go? People. Where did those last 10 years go?
Hang the fuck in there, will you? God damn. Yeah.
March 4th, 1994.
March 4th, yep. I thought it was my birthday, yeah.
Wow.
404, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, that's 25 years. See, I did the math like that.
There was a lot of stuff going on in 94.
I'll tell you what. Let's,
Chris Farley was 97. Belushi was 82.
Yeah.
And Ramis was, 2000. Oh, my God. Ramis was 2014?
Harold Ramis, yeah.
Yeah.
So the same time. And he died on Nikki's birthday. 24, day before mine. John Candy was 6'2". Why do I think he was shorter and fatter?
He's a big bitch. When we did that movie of The Great Outdoors, mm-hmm. up there at the ice house, yeah. I met him in person. Dude, as tall as me, but as like 3 meters wide. I mean, a big beast. Mm. Yeah.
I heard that people went out to, like, he was that generous type of guy.
Mm-hmm.
That he was that guy, if you ever pulled out a wallet or money when he was there, he was offended and pissed.
Yeah.
I read that like from 3 or 4 different people that he was offended. That you would try, that he was in the room and you tried to pay. And it's like, wow.
Well, yeah, if I had that kind of money, I'd probably do the same. But right now I'm still like saying, you know, you owe me $1 from IHOP. So I'm slowly trying to build that back up. Donna, give us a few weathers.
Hey, guys. No, I was saying 1994, that's when the O.J. Simpson, you know, the murders happened.
That was 94?
It was 94, yeah, because I was looking at...
Yeah, that makes
sense. Certain things, I put it into perspective, like my kids' ages and things like that. So I remember 1994 was the Northridge earthquake, the O.J. Simpson. There were a lot of things happening. That's probably why...
That was a dazzling year. I didn't
remember. It's weird, because when a lot of things happen at one time, within a short span, then... Some things get fuzzy, you know, like I didn't remember that he died around that time.
Yeah, it takes away that kind of thing.
It's like when Michael Jackson died and Farrah Fawcett died, what, on the same day or something? And then everybody kind of forgot. Yeah.
Tough shit, lady.
This is crazy. Oh, good. We'll do this after you do weather, because that's rude.
Okay. So,
give us about three. Three weather reports. Okay.
Good morning, everybody. It is 74 degrees currently and sunny in Rancho Cucamonga. It's going to be oh so much cooler today. The high will only be 99 today.
Oh so much cooler?
Oh so much.
Oh so much cooler.
Oh so much cooler today. It's coming down a little, they said a little bit each day, so it won't be as unbearable as yesterday. Sedona, Arizona, it's 81 degrees and sunny, and the high will be 100 degrees today. East Coast, New York, 84 degrees right now, sunny. And 91 is the high today. Pretty hot and sunny.
Excellent.
Across the nation.
A nice mild summer going on right now. Excellent. I'm going to fire this baby up here. Get Roy a little prime the pump. A little prime the pump. Get this thing a little blasted up here.
Say what?
I love that.
We are in the Roy and Jim in the Morning Fast Times Helicopter.
All right, Hamilton. Yes.
15 freeway southbound starts to back up around Oak Hill. Looks like slow and go all the way down, about 45 miles an hour until you get to the 215 split and then opens up. Unfortunately, again, right around the 210, it's backing up because of a big rig in the center divider with the wreck. That's bad. 210 freeway westbound. It's kind of busy all the way from the 15 to Carnelian. If we look out the road, that's where it starts clearing up. And then again in Glendora, you'll see some more slowing right around Sunflower. 71 freeway southbound. Guess what? Euclid Avenue. Yep. Sucks.
Yep.
91, it's usually a mess. Even worse, crash around the right shoulder at Auto Center Drive. Also, crash along the right shoulder at the 15. So you got two of those down there. It's going to be ugly. And let's give you one more big red mark.
Go red, baby.
Go red, bitches. I don't see anything that's like a big red ugly. So we'll go yellow.
Let's go yellow.
Work zone. I-5 Santa Ana North at the San Diego Freeway. On-ramp closed due to bridge work. So that is your first Fast Times and your only Fast Times. Roy and Jim in the Morning. Helicopter update.
First and only.
Here on Roy and Jim in the Morning.
We have Evan chiming in on the YouTube chat room. Hey, buddy, if you need any more help with your mother-in-law, let us know.
So this is crazy.
Okay, what do you got?
When Donna said, and this is how the show takes the direction we talk
about.
Yeah, yeah. We do have things we like to talk about, and I'll have a little list. Where's my list?
Exactly.
He will have a little list.
I just realized I don't have my list.
That's exactly what he's talking about.
Yeah, yeah.
I have a little list of things I want to talk about. I got to transfer some of these from yesterday to today. But anyway, she said 1994, we lost Candy. And then she started talking about the different things that happened in 94.
There were a lot of things in the news, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Watch. U.S. events. So, I mean, this world events. Okay, whatever.
Is this a this day in history kind of thing?
Kind of. Okay. It's off info, please.
It's all 94, right?
So, 94. On January 6th, figure skater Nancy Kerrigan was attacked in 94.
Why?
Why? Why? Why?
I do remember this. I don't care.
I don't care.
Four men were convicted for the World Trade Center bombing on March 4th.
Oh my god!
Birthday.
My birthdays.
Clinton was accused of sexual harassment while in the governor office. No shit.
So 94. I was
65, 75, 85, 95, 29. So, O.J. Simpson was arrested in the killings of wife Nicole Brown Simpson and friend Ronald Goldman on the 18th. How about this one? Major League Baseball player strike.
Yeah, this one I tuned out.
And then finally you're back. Now, entertainment. Kurt Cobain kills himself.
Damn, that's a year.
95 million viewers watch O.J. Simpson. Spielberg wins his first directing Oscar for Schindler's List.
His first one?
Yep.
Wow.
Yeah, he was nominated many times, but took a while to win.
Yeah.
Tom Hanks wins his second consecutive Best Actor Oscar
for Forrest Gump.
For his role in Philadelphia. Oh, no. Philadelphia's first in 94 for Forrest Gump.
Ah.
ER and Friends debuted on NBC.
Who does?
ER and Friends.
Oh, damn. My gosh. Wow. Really?
Shit world.
And the movies in 94. Forrest Gump, Pulp Fiction, Shawshank Redemption, Quiz Show, and Nobody's Fool. That is crazy. That was that long ago.
See, I'm in that mode. I think a lot of people are when we get to be older. It's like everything's about 5 years ago. You're like, remember when that happened? About 5 years ago.
Yeah.
But then you're like 10, 12, 15, 25. You're like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
How about this one? White House launches its first webpage.
the internet. That's when I opened my business was 94. And everyone's going, you really need to get your stuff online. I'm like, for who? Who the fuck is doing this? Ariana popped in. She goes, that same year Al Gore invented the internet. So there you go.
There you go. And deaths. Deaths of 94.
Uh-huh.
Is this a good song for that?
Yeah, it's good.
Okay.
The elephant.
Wait, let's try this one here. And who died in 94?
Here we go. Richard Milhouse Nixon.
Nixon went down?
I bet his name was never said by playing this song.
No. only when he was president.
Cab Calloway.
Cab Calloway, wow. Mm.
Burt Lancaster.
Lancaster.
Oh, wow.
John Candy, we knew. Mm-hmm. Jacqueline Kennedy Onassis.
Oh, wow. That's another big one.
That's
a
year right there.
Tip O'Neill, and here's one, Jessica Tandy.
Oh, gosh. Remember, she was beautiful.
She
was like 100 years old.
No batteries required and cocoon.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. There she is. She was born in 1909. Died in 94.
Well, she seemed even older. But she was... I think she was working as an actress up into her 80s.
Well, here she won Streetcar Named Desire, Tony Awards for A Gin Game, Foxfire. She played in several films, Driving Miss Daisy, Fried Green Tomatoes, yeah. The Birds, Cocoon, Used People, Nobody's Fool. He also owned a law degree in 74.
Great movies.
That's crazy.
Evan asks, who won the Indy 594? So you tell us, race guy.
I don't know. It doesn't say.
You're the man.
I don't think I saw that.
Wow. 94 was a busy, busy year.
Yeah, it was.
Let's see, sports. Let's see if it goes to sports. It doesn't go to sports. Oh, yeah, sports. Super Bowl. Dallas beat Buffalo. World Series was not held due to the strike. Houston won the NBA championship. Rangers beat Vancouver.
That was a strong team. Rockets that year?
Oh, yeah.
Strong.
It's Pete Sampras, the chimp. He was there. Gopher Gin won the Derby. Arkansas beat Duke. Doesn't say anything about Indy. Nebraska was the football champion.
Brazil
beat Italy. I can look it up, but we don't really care.
Here you go. Al Unser Jr. won 1994 Indy 500. Good job, Evan. Good job, buddy.
Al Unser Jr. And I wonder.
I'm keeping this up for everybody today, Donna, because Evan's done such a great job of participating and viewing.
Yeah.
So if someone does something, I'm giving everyone a prop there. So Evan, thank you, sir, for the Indy 500 winner information. Right here, we're in the morning.
He's our Texas correspondent.
Our Texas correspondent.
And yeah. Anyone wants to know the NASCAR champion of that year was.
Back then, was that Earnhardt?
Yep.
Yep. Dale Earnhardt. Senior.
Yeah, he beat out Rusty Wallace.
Nice.
I was a big Mark Martin fan. Everyone that kind of knows me and knows NASCAR knows I just love that guy. I follow him on Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
This dude's freaking hilarious. Mm. If something happens, he'll just put up bullshit. I mean, he just types what he feels.
Yeah.
But one of the stories about him and Earnhardt, he was always chasing Earnhardt, and for whatever reason, Mark never got his championship. Just never fell together.
Didn't get that pocket.
Nope.
Slip in there.
And Harvick, who I'm a fan of now, Mark was almost ready to win Daytona, and it was a caution flag, and Harvick scooted by him with a caution just by a second. But anyway, Harvick's an asshole, but I love him. I think he's the only guy that would have beat him that and said, let the guy win. And Harvick said, hell no. But anyway.
Hell no.
Anyway, there was one season, I think it was, I don't remember, 2001 or something, that during the pace laps, Mark Martin had a problem. And they put him to the back. No. His steering jacked up, and during the pace laps, all of a sudden it turned left on him, and he couldn't get it back.
Right.
So he found out if he got it past 30 degrees, it would lock left. So he got it back and said, okay, just go 30 degrees. They put him in the back. He had some damage, finished around back. He had a car to win. He had a car to be top five. If he had not done that, he'd have won the championship. That thing. Anyway,
so cool.
But the story I was going to is... Earnhardt, intimidator guy. Right. I'm losing everyone right now, except for Evan. So intimidator guy.
So how you been, Donna?
They go to practice one time. Let's see if Evan's talking about. Okay. So
this is history, Evan.
Evan. So they're going to go practice one time, and this is documented, that Earnhardt and Martin were practicing at the same place. Rented track time.
Mm-hmm.
So Earnhardt's running, or Martin's running it with Roush, just trying to beat it up. Man, we got to do something to catch this Earnhardt guy. So I guess Dale went over to crew chief and said, we're not doing long runs. We're not doing anything. I want you to make this thing as fast as you can for like two or three laps. That's it. He says, well, we're going to learn. I don't care. So they get out there. They do kind of a warm-up lap, and then they blast it out. Just put down lap times crazy, like two or three laps.
So just those two on the track.
Yeah, yeah. And they go at separate times.
Right.
But they know what everyone's doing. They're
sure.
Timing them. You know, once crew's going, see what they're doing. So he does it, runs like two or three laps, just lights the track on fire. Well, he probably couldn't have gone 10 laps at that speed.
Right.
It's just you can make a quick run fast. And when you're doing testing, you want to see how fast you can go for the longest time. So Earnhardt puts it out, goes out, burns the freaking track up for two or three laps, and then pulls it into pits and says, all right, put it on the trailer. And they were going way faster than the Roush team had gone all day.
Right, right.
And they just said, put it on the trailer. So, well, that's like a short run. We need to, put it on the trailer. So he was mind-fucking him.
Yeah.
And they kind of, all the Roush guys and Mark went, oh, you're never going to catch this guy. And they said he kind of broke his spirit that year.
Just crushed him right there. Yes, mental.
So was that the, Evan, remember when Sterling Martin got out and adjusted his car? That was funny. That's just for Evan.
That's just for him. Gotcha.
Move off of NASCAR.
I gotta transfer my stories from yesterday to today.
Yes, you do. Yeah, because it's what your mom say here? She misses NASCAR and NASNaps.
NASNaps. Used to go watch NASCAR at mom's house on Sundays.
You gotcha.
And go sit out, and David be there, and mom would make breakfast.
Yeah.
And we'd go over there and fire off a good old breakfast, watch NASCAR,
and just kind of like slumber off from all the food, the food coma.
Now the funny thing is we'd always wake up to the end, you know.
Yeah.
But you could be like half asleep, and you hear "Caution's out," and it was like you wake up, look, all right, see what's going on, and kind of back to sleep, and that was one of the best times. And wake up, watch finish the race, go take a poop, and your day's good.
You know what I'm going to do?
What are you going to do?
I think I started taking NASA.
I think everyone will see what I'm going to do. I think everyone will see what I'm going to do here. This is
going to
be
hilarious. Okay. Hilarity will ensue.
It will ensue. Trust me on this one here. But yeah, the Sunday NASCAR is all that. Let's see, where's my last one here?
Boy, I really
hope I kept it. Anywho.
I hope I kept it, because it sounds like it's going to be gold.
It would have been.
It would have been. Maybe it's not there.
Here we go. I'm going to do it right now. Do it right now. Guys, do some filler.
There's one right there. There's a story I was looking for. Okay.
Give me some.
Oh, my God.
Donna, you sneak peeking this.
Uh-oh.
I was going to say, don't ever get an amusement park ride that's made in India.
What'd you do? What'd you do to India?
Two dead and dozens injured after a flying amusement park ride splits midair in India.
I saw that.
Yeah. Somehow.
The one we're going to read, but I don't want to read it yet because it like kind of blown her wad early.
It's okay. Yeah. We'll find some other things to talk about. Anyway, yeah, it doesn't sound like they have a lot of regulations on those building those rides over there.
No,
you know those
traveling
carnivals always make me nervous, those rides. You always feel like
did you see
somebody put it together with a rubber band and
boing.
Yeah.
Did you see the one that happened not too long ago where the lady fell off it and then it kind of swept her off when it came down and got her again?
Oh, no.
It was like one of those same kind of spinny ones. She went up and fell out. It went upside down, fell out on the platform.
Where was this? Do you remember?
I don't remember.
It was in the U.S. somewhere.
And then it fell on the platform. And then it came down again and hit her and launched her off like they were taking a golf shot.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh.
That's not good.
And, you know, sometimes you look at the guys operating those rides and you're like, maybe not.
That's like below minimum wage going on there.
Speaking of which, the Orange County Fair... Didn't it start this weekend?
Yes, it did. It started this week. Yep.
Because we know the LA County Fair is coming in September.
It'll be here.
So Orange County always goes July to August. Some days in July and August. Yes. When you know what? The Orange County Fair, they have some great concerts down there. They have a couple of different venues.
And our fan base is a... is just loving Roy in our YouTube chat there. we'll take
you guys
here.
Got a list or something? I got it.
Roy's getting that going. In fact,
hey, David. David, Mr. Morrow. Psst. Shut it.
Go cook something.
Yeah, put something on your gas grill.
Tell him to take a NAS nap.
Although I got to tell you the other day, using your Dutch oven, it looked like type of thing. Looked like you did all right. Tell me how that turned out, man. That was like really good.
That's a little personal.
No, you saw him cooking it. Right?
I'm sure. Yeah.
Looked delicious.
It did.
He got a good crust on it. Got it going.
Nice.
You know, David's good and crusty.
Nice. It's 801. It's Roy and Jimmy in the morning with Donna Van. Give us a call at
909. Mody Poppins.
Quit popping, Donna.
4063. That's been a NASCAR day.
I liked it.
Smooth. Steely Dan. Welcome back to Roy and Jimmy in the Morning.
Was that smooth?
That was smooth. Oh, I haven't heard that song for a long time. That was fun. It was
sounds
fun.
Like
I was,
that. She sounds
I was
like
dancing
that.
Around this big studio here.
She sounds like that lady member used to be on Coast at Night, Delilah.
Yeah, smooth jazz.
Your smooth request right here on Coast 103.
That's right. Well, welcome back to Roy and Jimmy in the Morning. Live 365 RJ Radio. All right, guys.
Yes, yes. Do it, Donna.
Ooh, how's everybody doing?
Do that shit, Donna.
Get some coffee and a...
Do that shit.
Yeah.
Do that
great
shit.
Great song.
Hook us up.
I was just going to say, I think it's happy birthday time, Mr. Roy.
Now, Roy, do you want to go on the clock or do you want to take some time? I'm gonna let that be.
We're already 8:15. Let's burn it.
You want to go on the clock?
Yeah.
Okay. Roy Brewster, you're on the clock for celebrity birthdays.
All right. Here we go, guys. Celebrity birthdays, July 16th. Are you ready?
No.
Oops, sorry. I put you on the clock too soon. I'm hitting all the wrong shit.
That's
hang
funny.
On. Give me a moment now, and I'm fucking this up. Okay, go.
Okay.
So first celebrity birthday.
First one, actor / comedian Will Ferrell.
He's our age.
That's your answer.
Southern California.
That's your
dude.
Final.
Yeah.
That's your final answer.
Local guy.
53.
Oh, so close.
Damn it!
So close. He is 52 today.
Dude, yes. Right there.
Well, he's our age. That's not
exactly.
Our age.
Yeah. Exactly.
I knew he was our age.
Just
he was
one
right
year.
There in with
yeah.
him. All right. Number two.
Okay. Child actor.
Who?
And I was trying to think of other ways to describe him.
Drug addict. Recovering
drug
addict.
So many things.
Michael Jackson, buddy boy.
Corey Feldman.
Oh. He's close to our age.
The surviving
Corey. Let's
take
some off of him.
Yes, the
let's
one.
Take 4, 5, 40. 49.
Once again.
Ah!
He's 48 today. Wow.
Damn, you're in the zone.
You're almost right on.
You are in the zone, though.
Oh. I got to hit one.
Okay.
I feel
okay. We got one more, right?
Okay,
we
have one more for you. All right. Think about this one. I don't know if you were one of the guys that used to swoon over her. Actress Phoebe Cates.
Oh.
You know what? I'm not going to even put you on this clock. I'm going to give you something else for Phoebe Cates. Here we go. Here we go, Roy. No, just brace yourself. Dude, I got to get you in the mood. I got to get you in the mood, honey.
Fast times, I was in high school. She's coming out of the water right now.
Let's get you in the mood here.
Hamilton's beating the bishop. She's watching her come out of the pool. She's still beautiful.
I haven't seen a recent picture, but yeah. I can only assume.
And she's still married to Kevin Klein,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
Yeah, they've been married a long time.
All right, go.
Okay, I remember going to see Fast Times when it came out. I was probably a junior or senior in high school. And believe it or not, I went with my parents. And I remember Eddie Oliver's parents took him. and they left because they were really
offended,
God-fearing. And they took him out, and we sat there and watched the whole thing. So I'm thinking Phoebe, I was probably 18-ish, 17, 18. She had probably had a couple years on us. So maybe three. So she was acting by then.
Yeah, she
so
started
we'll just
out.
Go with two or three. So I'll put two or three on her. Let's go 50. Damn, is she that old? She got. So if I was 18, that means she was 20. Was she really acting that movie when she was 20, 21 years old? Probably. She looked that old. And she was young. Because then she did Gremlins afterwards, right?
Right after.
So then she was a little older and she had that little lisp. She kind of had the lisp a little bit like Drew had. Man, I'm getting in a bad zone right now. So. 56.
You got it. 56 today. Woo. Oh my goodness. You said you had to get one and you got one right on. And the other two you only missed by one.
Okay.
All right. Oh in the zone, gosh. Buddy. In the zone.
All right.
Wow. Excellent. That is impressive.
And so as popular demand, Roy, you got a list or something? Or what do you got? You've been transposing notes.
I was transposing from this to the other. So this is, I don't know if I got time for this. More birthday I sent a message to. Hi, Desert Friend.
Yes.
Claudia Cortez's birthday today.
Claudia Cortez. Oh. And then my gal, Jenna from work, Jenna Wood, today is her birthday. Happy birthday, Jen.
Yep.
And as far as Lori Kilmartin, today is her birthday. Happy hilarious,
oh,
gal.
Lori.
Yep. And so there's your birthdays right there.
I think I did a show with. Yeah, I did. Yeah, I did.
Lori?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's great.
So where is the other one? This is work. That's not it. It is. Oh, it's a site. No, it's a site. Where is it? Son of a bitch. Who's K? Someone telling me not to accept a message from him.
Mm.
Whatever. But they sent a message.
Yeah. This is for Jimmy.
Me?
Yep. All for Jimmy.
Oh, did you guys pitch in on something?
Yeah. This story's all for Jimmy.
Did you put Donna's name on it?
That was a harsh
picture. Yeah, but that's not what goes there.
That's not what goes with the thing.
But every time when Warren says that, I always just turn my way toward Donna I don't accidentally see anything because I generally want to be surprised.
Yes. Oh yes, you're going to love this.
Starting in September in this state. I'm trying to find out what state it's at before I get any further.
Okay. Yeah.
Why doesn't that say it?
Oh my God.
It does say it right there. Where? Second paragraph.
Oh, there it is.
Second paragraph.
There it is. Starting in September in Alabama.
If you are
caught driving in the left lane for more than a mile and a half without passing other cars,
you will
be breaking the law.
You are breaking the law. You're not going to be. You are breaking the law.
Alabama's Department of Transportation said it plans to use all 30 of their digital messaging systems statewide to get word out about the new anti-road rage law.
This is me. Mm. Here's how I feel.
Oh, God.
Yes. You ignorant sons of bitches.
One of the things that we do with our message boards, Interstates Communicate Public Service. So get ahead to encourage people to start practicing safe driving habits like driving on the right only if passing on the left.
Yes.
The law states that a driver cannot go more than a mile and a half on the left lane of an interstate without passing other cars.
Yes.
The worst thing is about somebody passing another person and you could all get past the second or third person ahead. That's not a place for road rage, but it'll probably happen. You're going to have an official to be there to check it. As far as being ticketed by people, people will go around. Before the law takes effect, there will be a 60-day warning period before the citations begin. The anti-road rage law goes into effect September 1st.
This is me. You reading that whole thing. Can you read that again, but slower?
They call this the Jimmy Shaw law.
Yes, if you just read that right again really slow.
God.
That's the best thing I've heard right there.
It's got a bit of a stiffy.
I am chubbed up on that law. I love that.
All right.
Yes, Roy, thank you so much. That you, sir, are a giver. You are a giver. I love it.
CNN reports. A Tennessee Police Department is warning residents to stop flushing drugs down their toilet and sinks out of fear they could create meth gators.
Well, we talked about this yesterday. And I was looking because they say they have gators all the way from Central Texas, Evan.
Meth gators.
And from there and east. And we were talking about the hurricane.
She's already trying to think.
I'm Italian. I'm thinking with my hands. Thinking with my hands. With that hurricane Barry. That all these gators and snakes and all these things are like all over, floating all over the place. So they have a huge gator problem.
But now we have meth gators.
In the south, and now it's going to be meth gators.
So now our sewer guys take great pride in releasing the water that's cleaner than when it was in the creek, but they are not really prepared for meth, according to Loretto Police Department social media post.
They're not prepared for meth?
Right.
Who is?
Ducks,
really?
Geese, and other fowl frequent our treatment ponds, and we shudder to think what one all hyped up on meth would do.
Well, geese can be mean. Whoa, right? can you imagine that?
I'm picturing them, when they go low. Those wings are, oh my
coming
God.
Imagine after that. Your ass
imagine that shit to meth. The 1,000%.
The police posted a warning to the Facebook page on Saturday
after officers found a suspect unsuccessfully trying to flush methamphetamine and paraphernalia at their home. The suspect was arrested, but police say it's becoming a bigger issue for the city because drugs in the sewer system end up in the retention ponds for processing before they're sent downstream. Police warn that if drugs make it far enough, they'll end up being consumed by gators in Shoal Creek. They've had enough methed up animals the past few weeks without our help, so police wrote.
Oh my God.
You were so methed up.
Loretto police urge residents to bring any drugs, including prescription medication, into their offices for proper disposal instead of flushing. Methed up gators.
Can you imagine?
Evan chimed in and says,
like, they're not scary enough already. Yeah.
Evan chimed in and says he has a pet gator. No, that's your mother-in-law. That's downstairs. Yeah. And then your mom, your mom got me for impersonating her. She says, Jimmy, I suggest you not make fun of my technology. Remember, I know secrets. And but she can't sign in under her account. She knows where that little devil emoticon is. Of course, it's mom. All in love, babies. All in love.
Yeah, I thought that was funny. I knew the one.
Meth gators. That's meth a,
yeah. Well, remember the squirrel? They had the squirrel.
That's right, a couple weeks ago, right?
Attack squirrel.
That's right. Yeah, that squirrel was evil.
I mean, that's what drugs are doing to Animal Planet here.
I already got to deal with these asshole people on drugs. Now I got to worry about wildlife.
Yeah, really. That's terrible.
I don't want to do that.
No.
I do not want to do that.
I have a list I was trying to work on so I can get the video going. I mean, get something going.
Do you
going
want
for
just a
them?
Little quick hunk report here?
Oh, that'll end the show.
I'll tell you what. You got a quick one? Do a quick one.
Just one little note here.
Okay that'll let me add stuff to this.
There you go.
So one.
All right, let's give Donna. It's been a while since you've heard this one here.
I mean, I don't know if you think this guy's a hunk, but he's.
It's all yours. It's, but let me set you up here because it's been a while.
Thank you. Boy, Jimmy, you ain't kidding. It has been a while. Okay.
Hunk of music.
Now I am really looking forward to July 26th. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood.
I do want to see
comes
that.
Out.
Yes.
And that movie is full of hunks and a lot of incredible actors. The whole look of it to me, I know it's, you know, it parallels a lot of tragedy, but the 60s, you know, late 60s look of the film, it just looks so cool. Yeah. I really want to see it. So Quentin Tarantino, I don't think of him as a hunk, but he makes a lot of films with hunks.
You were gonna get a boot right in the ass if you ever said that guy was your hunk for the day.
Boot.
But he's interesting and he has a lot of hunks in his movies. Quentin Tarantino broke the hearts of many fans earlier this month by reminding them that he is still planning to retire from filmmaking after helming his 10th feature film.
Yeah,
so I guess that was always his plan, was only to make 10 blockbuster-type movies.
I've enjoyed probably all of his movies. Good for you. Go out on top. Get out of here. And then so give us some hunks out of this movie, because there's old and young hunks in this movie.
Yeah. So Once Upon a Time in Hollywood is his 9th directorial effort. And now he is deciding if he is going to do his next movie, if the next movie will be Star Trek, if that's going to be his final filmmaking project. He says if he commits to directing Star Trek, that's his last movie.
You know what? It's Samuel Jackson's always in his movies. So if he does Star Trek right, I would like him to put Samuel L. Jackson as Scotty in the engine bay. And he says, you know, when they start saying, hey, Scotty, give me more. I can't motherfucking do this more. Go fuck yourself. Push it, Scotty. Fuck you. That'd be great. Pulp Fiction, Star Trek would be awesome.
And of course, if he does it, it's going to be R-rated. Tarantino successfully pitched an R-rated Star Trek to producer J.J. Abrams and Paramount and has written a script. So he even has the script. The studio has yet to officially greenlight the project, but if they do, and if Tarantino decides to direct it, that will probably be his last movie.
So who's your hunk?
No. Yeah, he's the one directing all the hunks.
Gotcha. So what you did.
I'm saying...
You did a hunk
topic.
I don't
think of him as a hunk, but I am so looking forward to this movie coming out in a couple weeks.
I'm going to applaud you.
He is quite the director. I mean, he's made some incredible stuff.
I'm going to applaud you for this one.
He's very unique. I'll have to say that.
You did a hunk subject instead of a hunk. That's a very, very plausible. So very
thought,
nice.
But I thought it was interesting. Yeah.
Well, we have to wrap up.
To mention that he only plans on doing one more film.
No, that was
isn't that crazy?
That was great. Well, you know, we got to shut this down just a couple minutes early. Roy's got a thing at 9.
So we're going to do a list.
We're going to get a list together, but I'm going to take our last break right now.
Okay. Fast one, because I want to get through this. This could be fun. I'm going to wake up the chat room.
There you go. Wake them up. It is Roy and Jimmy in the morning. It is 8:30 in the morning, Tuesday, July 16th already.
You're kidding me.
If you guys dare, give us a call at 909.
509
4063. Hurry up.
Chat us up on the YouTubers. Too much.
Welcome back to Roy and Jim in the morning here on Live 365 and YouTube. We can't forget about our YouTube peeps.
Can't never forget about your YouTuber.
So I got your list, and we got to hurry up. We got to hurry up that much.
No, we're good. We'll push through. I think we're covered through.
I have. This is going to start.
You have.
I have top 500 best songs ever.
Number 500. Let's start with 500.
No.
No.
We're going to do top 10, of course.
Obviously.
We could do 500 for a...
we can do... Just break
500,
it up.
500 for a... what do you call it? Your A to Z weekend.
Yeah, but actually, if we do like 10 every day...
Best songs ever?
You know, 10 every show.
Yeah, best songs ever.
Who compiled this list?
Oh, my God. How long do you think we have? 2-hour show, Donna.
Dude, if we do 10 a show, this is like the best filler for our show.
It's actually rateyourmusic.com.
Rateyourmusic.com, the top greatest songs? Is that what we're talking?
Yes, it is. Okay. Best top 500 songs ever.
Alrighty.
Forever. What movie is that from?
Do you have links on this thing?
Yeah, I do. That's what I was working on.
Yeah, boy. All right, shut this shit down. Let's do this.
We'll just show you where we're at. We'll just go 15. We're not going to do anything. 15, American Pie. 14, The Clash, London Calling. Number 13, Sex Pistols. Never mind the Bullocks. Here's the Sex Pistols. Number 12, The Who. Who's next? And number 11,
those are albums. You guys say that.
I said Train the Vein. Oh, I didn't say Train the Vein. Save the Queen and Bob O'Reilly. Number 12.
There you go.
And Dancing in the Dark for Born in the USA.
That was 15 to 11.
Well, I said that's what happened. I said American Pie, and that was the name of the thing. Okay, gotcha. So here we go. Number 10.
Number 10.
I got to turn this volume on to make sure it's ready to go. And turn this one on. And here we go. Number 10.
Maybe plug in your...
Uh-oh.
Remember where you got to push it all the way in.
Ooh, it's buzzing. We're getting a buzz.
I don't want to sing that buzz.
Either that or Roy needs Beano.
Someone needs
number 10.
Great song.
Yes. I'm on board with this one.
She likes the list all of a sudden. Number 10.
Well, some of those other ones I really don't understand, but okay.
Let it be. Let it be.
Paul played this on Saturday.
And here's the deal. I'm a fan of the song.
Love the song.
So I don't shit on everything Beatles.
Oh, well.
That's good to know.
Yeah.
All right. Number 9.
Number 9. Again, another song that I really like from one of those people.
One of those people.
Let's go. Got a forward. A lot of intro here.
A lot of filler.
A lot of welcome. Wow. Yes, it's Imagine for another one of those people.
Something soothing about a piano song.
Just imagine that. Unless you're singing Ebony and Ivory on the piano. So another one. Another good song by one of those people that I enjoy.
Very nice.
Very good.
Okay, so far the list is not disappointing.
Mm-hmm. Number 8. And we just talked about this kind of this song earlier with Phoebe Cates.
Is this 8?
Yep.
Oh, I thought we skipped one.
No, 10, 9 with two Beatles. We're at 8.
Okay. No, I saw another one there and I thought it was when we go back to the list.
And we're a lot of intro.
Yeah.
Hello, hello.
This is getting some stone music right here.
Yeah, right. This is.
When they have the laser light show at Griffith Observatory.
Oh yeah, many, observatory back went in the to day. That many yeah. years ago.
So it is Dark Side of the Moon, yeah. Pink Floyd. Pink Very nice. Floyd. Number 8. Okay. Number.
See that was that.
Oh
was,
wait, what happened?
That was 7.
Oh, that
That's
was 7.
What I thought. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
that was
yeah.
7. Here's number 8.
Which I like this one better. Personally.
This is the one I was actually looking for. This is Phoebe yeah. Cates from Fast Times.
As a rat was telling him, say, Rat, if you want to get lucky, side for Led Zeppelin.
So that is number 8. The other one was number 7.
Gotcha.
And we're back on track.
I'm nice. Not so, I don't, I'm not that big on the Pink Floyd. I don't know.
That's all right. I'm shitty on the Bengals. Beatles.
Yeah,
the Bengals.
The Bengals.
Jesus Christ, you two, could you shut up? God damn.
Number okay, so 6.
We're at number 6. Which one's this?
Crown Tumble.
Wow, I haven't heard this in years.
I know it.
These are supposed to be the best songs of all time.
Mm-hmm. I like it. You know what I like about it is it's not the typical.
Right! Right, what's happening in the chat room?
Your mom said this was our favorite, which wasn't this song. It was probably 3 or 4 back.
Oh, no, it was. I know it was. It was Lennon.
Gotcha. All right. So a little CCR at number 7.
Number 7. Stop this.
Nice.
Number 6. Oh, wait.
Number 5.
That was 5. We got a 5. This one surprises me. A little bit. A lot.
Oh, my God. What a strange list. Best songs of all time?
Yep.
What?
Top 500.
Oh, no. I don't think
it's probably,
so.
It's probably the most popular.
That's weird.
I years ago, a gal sang this at karaoke, and oh, my God, it made me erase my name on the list. She hit it out of the park.
Yeah.
No?
I would go with popular, sure.
It's popular.
Well, I don't know about popular when it comes to all those.
One of the best songs ever? No.
Yeah, no, not best songs.
No. No.
All right. Mm-mm. I totally agree with number 4.
What's happening? I'm not even going to look. I'm not even going to look. Surprise me, big
totally.
Boy.
Totally. And I'm kind of wondering if Jimmy's going to shit on it. It's going to bother me.
No, I love the song.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, it's a great song. Great California song.
Definitely top 5.
Yeah. The harmonies, the melodies, the music is perfect. It's so era specific too.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I just want to listen to it.
No, I love the song.
So that's 4. Oh. Gotta love it.
Great sound.
Number 3. I might get shit on.
Oh, I was just thinking about them, but this is probably not my favorite song that they did, but
it's iconic.
But they are.
Yeah.
I've been listening to some of their stuff lately and oh my God, Art Garfunkel's voice.
Yeah.
Was incredible.
No, it is a great song.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But not one of my favorites, but it's a great song. I bet you're wrong, Evan. Because I bet Skindred's in the top 3. Yeah, it probably isn't.
Well, this is actually number 3 right here.
My guess would be no.
Yeah.
But, you know, for the time, another era-specific song. You hear it, then you can kind of place the whole era and time, everything at the same time. It's a really good song. Really good
ready
song.
Ready to get upset? Number 2? I might agree with.
Let's see. Number 2.
Hmm.
Not looking. Donna, don't look.
It's right in front of me. I got it.
I'm going to leave it there.
You know why I'm going to leave it there? Because of everything that went into this song.
Yes.
They brought in
They brought in so many different things into it. First of all, it's like a cappella.
Yep. Operatic.
Operatic. They brought in the choir type thing. I think maybe not top two of all time as far as best songs ever, but definitely top two or three of a groundbreaking piece of music. How's that?
I'm agree. Yeah. And I just based on what I saw in the movie, the concept being rejected so hard but hitting so good when they said we're doing it anyways. No, it is a really good song. It's, again, not one of my favorites, but it's a good song. I shall play my piano. You notice a lot of these are piano.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Looks like I'm really doing it, huh, Donna?
Oh, yeah.
A little glance over. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's what I'm looking for.
Well, one of my personal favorites of all time is A Day in the Life by the Beatles. Talk about groundbreaking. That was when they brought in, you know, an orchestra and all the changes and everything.
Yeah, Sgt. Pepper, right?
That
album, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, and they definitely did
so that. Was,
the problem with that song, though, being there, I think it was groundbreaking, but the song still sucked. And that's why they had the problem.
Good Lord. It's amazing. And it's timeless. It's absolutely timeless.
So let's go
and
up.
And that was way before Queen, honey. So that was...
Well, yeah, but Queen did it right. There's a difference.
They changed music forever.
I can cut both your mics right now. I own this board.
So,
I've
now,
got
how do you
it
go
right
slow
here.
And then do a good... anyway, good song.
And then, of course, when he popped it into Wayne's World, just really brought it
hilarious.
All back, too. Perfect. Yeah. Just perfect.
All right, number one.
Number one, let's have it.
Now, this it surprised me that the list goes a long ways, but really doesn't pass anything past the early late 70s.
And, you know, I'm not mad at anything so far in this top 10. Everything, I think, we can be ranked there. It's fine.
Number one.
Not necessarily the numbers they're at, but...
Yeah.
Wow, that kind of came out of
didn't it?
I mean, it's a great song, but
I don't understand this, how they did this.
Yeah.
Top songs of all time.
Ooh, let that play a little bit. I haven't heard this in a long time.
Let it go.
Let me listen and discuss here.
It's a beautiful song and a beautiful rendition, and I just don't see the top 10 having
like I said, the rankings
totally Eclipse of the Heart.
Yeah, I don't agree with rankings, but
it's so bizarre.
Yeah, quality absolutely. Ranking, whatever. But I'm not mad at all. These are great songs. Good pull, Roy.
I was just looking at anyone else say anything. So,
your mom loves it.
Yeah, Don likes the list so far. Mm-hmm. So that's pretty good. I thought we're looking for something
like that. They're quality songs. Like I said, numbers, they're a little iffy, but I liked all.
I want to know what the criteria is, because
they just made a list. There's not a big freaking thing, though. They just said these are our favorite songs. It doesn't have to be anything else in it.
I already told you.
Jesus Christ! You guys, it says list by more best 500 ever by rateyourmusic.com. That's it. There's nothing else needs to happen.
So this is compiled from all kinds of things, probably from iTunes, Spotify, Pandora. I mean, these are just global numbers.
Yeah. Now, since we were listening about it, I always love to hear this one. This is Freddie Mercury, vocal stripped down. I love this. Love this when they do it.
Each morning I get up, I die a little. Can barely stand on my feet. Take a look in the mirror and cry. Lord, what you doing to me? I have spent all my years in believing you, but I just can't get no relief. Lord, somebody, ooh, somebody.
I love
can
that.
Anybody find me somebody to love?
I love that.
What was that Queen song that we had? It was supposed to be, a different version of it. It was a faster version. Doggone it, I can't remember it. I have to look
that
up.
You had to look it
up.
You
know what I'm talking about, though?
Yes, I do.
And it was like, holy shit.
So if we're going down a list, that we went to 15. But kind of know where they're at. I don't get this one. Oh, well, Forever Young was on there.
Yeah.
War is Over. Happy Christmas, War is Over. I love that one, too. The Verve, Bittersweet Symphony, huh? The Beatles, yeah. Help. Definitely probably deserves a top 20. The Beach Boys, come on. I Get Around. Now, that could be, there should be a list of top 100 California songs. How's that?
That would be good. I would enjoy that so good. That would
be, Donna, be interesting. Let's do a list of top 100 songs that we vote on. And we put it on there, then we'll be famous.
There you go.
Look at Donna. Okay. Shut up. Whatever. Queen, News of the World. From We're the Champions, of course.
We're the Champions. What is that?
When the Levee Breaks. Dream On, Aerosmith, 24.
What's number 22?
Terahoya Payahoya Mama.
What the hell is that?
Let's look it up.
It's probably something we've heard and we go, oh shit, that's it.
Yeah, let's see what happens. Let's see what happens.
These are like globally famous.
I don't know. Let's see what it is. Watch, we'll probably know it. Oh, here it is. Da, da, da. Wow, this is weird. Oh, it's really weird because it's Grammarly. Grammarly's trying to fix our spelling.
Here it is.
There it is. So this is the other one. Yes!
Oh, these motherfuckers.
These guys. Is that really it?
Oh, yeah. It is global. So
it's number that's 22. 22. What the hell?
Okay, this was that Queen version.
Do it.
This alternate version. We played this a few years ago on the night show, but it's a different version of We Will Rock You. And I like this so much more than the original.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Like this one. I remember we found this a few years ago.
What was the one you were looking at, Donna, when you said they broke it down? For
what's that?
When you said that song, the Beatles song you were looking at? Where you said that their groundbreaking
Oh, the groundbreaking was A Day in the Life.
Yes, Day in the Life.
Yeah, Day in the Life.
Let's see if they have it.
It's one of my very favorite songs ever. Probably my top three, maybe number one.
I've seen if it was on the list.
Oh, gotcha. Right.
No, it's not.
This list is so weird. They put that, whatever that was, that German song, or whatever that was, Der Walschen Total.
Well, let's go to 500. I want to see what's on the bottom of the
list. How could you put that before any
Iron
of
Maiden,
these other ones? I don't get it.
Iron Maiden's number 500. John Paul Young. Oh, Zeppelin's 497. The Beatles. I Feel Fine is 496. Bowie.
But the song they picked for Bowie is, what is it?
Yeah, but that's 500.
Yeah.
That's like way down a list.
But yeah. It's
the
like
Beatles have Twist and Shout at 492.
Huh. But to put that other song ahead of any Beatles song to me is bizarre. Well,
the Beatles aren't.
No,
the
but
best
that
thing
song
ever.
That's in a different language that.
And like, I don't see anything else a different. I wonder if they threw that in there to make you go, ooh.
Yeah, probably did.
I don't know. It's very strange. Yeah. I don't. Man, I'm not on board with this list.
Oh, right. You got to go, man.
Well, my wrist is going off, and
your wrist is going off.
Oh, London's Burning. The Clash is 447. Come on.
It's really weird. It's all over the place.
I think we should just do this list.
Oh, you just passed by what? The Sgt. Pepper thing. What song was that? Go up a little bit.
I just saw the. I'm looking for the. Where was it?
They had a picture of it. Stop.
Lovely Rita, 433.
Lovely Rita, okay.
433.
She's a meter maid.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I heard.
Yeah, it's a strong lyric right there, talking about a meter maid.
All right, guys.
Just like your country songs.
At least they talk about getting drunk.
Oh, yeah. Getting drunk and
getting drunk and touching women.
Lost my truck.
Lost my truck.
My boots don't fit anymore.
All right, we got to wrap this thing up. It is Roy and Jimmy in the Morning with Donna Mae. Thank you guys for listening. We'll be back next Monday and Tuesday, 7 to 9 a.m. in the Pacific time.
The Pacific?
So definitely
Could you be
tune
more
in.
Pacific,
Pacific, please. So definitely keep tuned into RJ Radio Classic Rock from the 70s, 80s, 90s, and the ooze. That's 24/7. And we, like I said, we'll be back next week.
We will. This month is going quickly.
Going quick.
Oh, my God.
All right. Get out of here, guys.
You guys all have a good week. We'll talk to you next Monday.
Have a great week. Love you. Bye.
Love you. Hit him, baby.